Hello, welcome back to Curl of Gaming, where we discuss all things video games, take a look at some gameplay footage, and reviews. Continuing with the Pinball series, I guess, of videos, going to take a look at Rush. Again, this is the Pro model. I just got this in about a couple weeks ago, and just finally got it all set up. What I haven't shown you since this video was recorded, I did swap everything out with Titan silicone rubbers. It does play a lot different with the silicone, and I find Titans are pretty good on this. Same with the balls, swapped them out, put their shiny ones in, just because of the magnetism on this game. But with that being said, let's break into it. Take a look at Rush Pro Pinball by Stern.
Double! the week.
Ready to take the top.
Welcome back. Hopefully you like that look at Rush Pro Pinball by Stern. This one's done by John Borg. There's been a lot of, I don't want to say controversy, but there's been a lot of feedback with him reusing certain playfield elements, a lot of copy and paste. And right away what people will say, oh, it's just X-Men with a few tweaks. There is a few things that Borg does like to use, especially that left cluster of pops with the shot through it. That's not just on X-Men, it's on a lot of his games, Kiss, Aerosmith, Indiana Jones, stuff like that. Just because he recycles certain elements doesn't mean it's a copy for copy. Even on X-Men, the scoop's in a totally different location. Pro Premium LE models do have the double scoop, so you see like there's a side in the front. On the Pro, even if you go on the side, it only kicks it out the front. Premium LE models will kick it out on either side depending what it's being called for, so you can have a dual kick out, and that's a pretty interesting feature to see in motion. So as for the Pro model, as what you just saw, the difference is, again, the Time Machine ramp, when it's active and when it's not, that ramp raises and lowers, whereas the Pro, it's programmed into the magnet, catches it. If it's not ready, it just spits it back out, whereas on the Pro and Premium, if the ramp's down, you just hit like a dead end and bounces back. There's a set of optos there. Speaking of dead ends, the Pro actually has a dead end target to the left of the Time Machine. Whereas on the Premium and LE, that is a VUK or a VUK in a separate wire form. So traps the ball, sends it back to the right hand side. Again, it's nice to have on the Premium and LE. It does slow it down a little bit, but I do prefer the dead end shot. Unlike the Led Zeppelin dead end shot, this one hits it, comes back right away, doesn't dribble out, dead end shot on Led Zeppelin, just, I don't know, it was nice to hit, but it wasn't satisfying. This one was more satisfying. Another feature on Premium and LE is a time clock drum that sits above the pops, does keep real time, as well as it keeps time when you're collecting time within the game. There's going to be certain modes, certain shots add time to the clock. You can actually see it on there. You don't get that on the Pro. And another feature is the hidden target behind the drops. Pro, it's just the hidden stand-up. You hit it, comes out. Premium LEs, there is actually a ball capture, like a fork that comes up, catches it, and it becomes a Newton ball. Hit the Newton ball, release it. So there is features for sure. LE definitely has the extra bonus of the expression light, which is not on the Premium or the Pro, and that's going to be a separate accessory. Has not been announced or released yet for the Pro and Premium. That is something I will be buying and adding on when it is released. Same with the scale or shooter rod and side armor. Again, no accessories have been announced for Rush at this time, and I believe they're behind on topper announcements for Godzilla and Mando. So when they're going to be announced, I'm guessing 2023. I think the accessories are really far behind when Stern's coming with that. As for the art package and stuff on Rush in general, I like all three models. The LE is phenomenal. If I'm not mistaken, it is foil decals, and it's a nice gold trim. It kind of looks like the Time Machine as well. And then the Premium, I know a lot of people think the Premium is kind of bland. It's, to me, it's not. It does feel like Rush, nice blue-black background with the satellite dishes, and then callbacks to the other album titles throughout. And then the Pro itself is a colorful cartoons of the band on the sides and that. Either way, I don't mind any of the art packages. I know a lot of people say, no, it's one or the other. I think that all art packages are in the same vein for Rush, so if you're a Rush fan, it suits the theme nicely. Another thing, since I'm Canadian, Rush is Canadian. There's a lot of Canadian jokes, Canadian assets in the back glass, like Big Money. You get the colorful Canadian play Monopoly money. There's even call-outs for the Monopoly money. Our loonies and toonies are represented, so that's our $1 and $2 that some Americans might not understand, but there's a lot of weird humor, and there is a humor setting on this game, and I have it maxed out. So I know one of the knocks this game gets is the callouts. I think the callouts are fine. The surviving band members themselves, Alex and Getty, are doing the callouts, and that, to me, it suits the theme just fine. Also, I find it funny that Neil and Alex are represented in the 70s form in the middle of the playfield, where Getty's kind of like the 90s version with the goatee and the tiny sunglasses, but is what it is. I think it flows. I think the art package is great and phenomenal, and I think they nailed this one as well. So again, I think Stern's 2 for 2, because this one came out right after Godzilla, and I'm glad I picked up the Pro. I did sell my Led Zeppelin to pick up Rush, and I don't regret that. I think Rush is a better game overall. Sound package, you get tons of songs on this. I believe 14 are right off the bat, and the other ones are for wizard modes. But they're full songs, and the way they use them in this is pretty interesting. So when you start up a game, doesn't matter what song you pick at first, that's what you're just going to be playing to, and then once you go into a mode, the song will kick in and then your shots will light up. Fly by Night is an amazing mode where the whole playfield is dark, and as you're trying to make your shots, I know some people think that's kind of, I don't want to say cheating, because once the lights go out, the GI goes out, and you're trying to make your shots, it does make it harder. I think that's one of the most amazing modes, is you're trying to make your shots in the dark, but is what it is. Some of the other shots in the game are pretty interesting. I'm still trying to get my game fully dialed in. For those that are unaware, dialed in is just trying to get the game so it plays 100%. One of the issues I'm having right now is the ramp diverter on my ramp, of course. as well as a clean shot from the upper flipper all the way to the right return. For some reason, there just seems to be a lot of ball hangups where the diverter sits, so I'm just trying to figure that out. And other than that, after I get the cleaned up ramp shots, that's pretty much it. This game is pretty much bang on. There is that inner loop where people say they can't hit that shot because the ball raises up. There is a few fixes for that, and I did order one, and it's just the clear Lex and the hold it in to keep the shot. I did try a different one, the Ninja mod, for that loop. I just found that kind of slowed it down for me, so I pulled it off and just waiting for the Lex in peace. Again, this game is another one you can throw tons of mods at and make it look the way you want it to. The game itself, for me, plays great. Even if people do compare it to some of Borg's other games, it is what it is, but this it just feels different. Like I said, people have compared it to X-Men. I don't think it plays anything like X-Men, and like I said, he does use certain elements. The main one for me is the pop bumpers on the left with the shot through it. That's fine if you have tons of games, like if you have all the board games side by side, maybe you'll see a lot of similarities. I don't, so right now I just got Godzilla and Rush and currently waiting on Ultraman, and that's going to be another whole different ball game. Especially since that one's kind of, it was dumped on pretty hard when it was first released, and it's starting to level out. So by the time I get mine, hopefully all that's figured out, mainly doing with the code. Speaking of code with this, just like Godzilla, this is 0.97, so it's come quite a ways since it was first released. I wasn't on an early run, so I got my game, like I said, late June. Early July, I believe. So, nope, it would have been late June. So, I've had it for a few weeks. At the time of this recording, it is July 26, 2022. And it's another game where, yeah, I can either have a really good game. When I say really good game, really good scoring game would probably be low to mid 100 million games, or score-wise. And my average games right now on it are pretty much 30 to 50 million. Basically, my strategy when I get a game is to find out where the shots are, where they line up on the flippers. Once the shots are pretty much laid out and I've got a feel for them, that's when I go into the rules and try to figure it out. So I see guys, billions of points, hundreds of millions of points. I'm just not quite there yet. So like I said, I'm probably average, and this is another one that the kids enjoy. They're not familiar with the music like I am, but it's the way the game plays. My son thinks it's head and shoulders above Led Zeppelin, and I think a lot of people would say that. Just because I'm more of a pro guy, I never go for the premium rallies. I do usually just pick up pros just because of the cost difference. So, with that being said, let me know what your thoughts are. Have you played a Rush before? For me, it's a phenomenal game, and Stern's usually, they'll have a great game followed by a lackluster game. Great game, lackluster, but for this, Godzilla, Rush, both were hits in my opinion, and apparently we're getting another one in August since they missed one just to catch up on the backlog. What that's going to be, I have no idea, lots of rumors, but I'm not going to go off rumors until I see the gameplay. Or the reveal anyway. So with that being said, let me know, have you played Rush before? Did you like it? I know some people aren't a fan of Rush's music, which is fine. But if you see one, give it a shot. The game is definitely worth it in my opinion. Anyway, let me know what your thoughts are down below, and I'll catch you next time. Thank you.